Our gospel lesson is from John chapter 10, starting with verse 11 and verse 18. Jesus says, "I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, who is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away, and the wolf snatches them and scatters. The hired hand runs away because the hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own and my own know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. I must bring them also. They will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it up again. I have received this command from my Father." It's the word of God for people to come.
Thanks be to God.
Right? If you're a Russian, I don't know.
Russian bear. If you're from England, you have the lion of England. But if you're from Israel, it's a sheep. We follow the shepherd because of our knowledge that we are helpless without the shepherd to lead and care and guide. Our psalter and our psalm. 23rd psalm, we know it. Most of us by heart, those 8 verses. The shepherd sets the path for the sheep, takes them to places of green pastures, provides for them still waters to drink from, and to cross. Even though they may face the valley of the shadow of death, they know they have the comfort that the shepherd is with them, with a rod and staff that comfort. You know what a rod is? A shepherd's rod. It's like a billing club. Okay? And I've got to remember what shepherds do. Even today, they pretty much just sit around and watch sheep. It's kind of a boring job to watch sheep all day. But they've got this rod, and they use it to protect the sheep from predators. You get a couple of shepherds together, what are they going to do? They're going to say, I bet you I can get that rod. Right? Next thing you know, there's shepherds throwing, you know, and they get good at it. That's what they do. They practice throwing the rod so they hit what they're aiming for. So that if a wolf comes to scatter the sheep, if a lion comes to devour the flock, the shepherd has his weapon, he has his rod. And he has a staff with a crook in it that he uses to get the sheep out of places they got themselves into, maybe over a ledge or stuck in, wedged in someplace. Or even laying on their sides, like I said. Because the sheep can't lay on the side. And he uses his crook and he moves the sheep. And he gets the sheep where he wants them to go. The good shepherd does that for his sheep. And the sheep follow him because they hear his voice. And they recognize his voice as the one that they need to go with. The hired hand, they don't recognize. The hired hand, though they may go along with them, because they have to, they don't feel quite as safe. Because the shepherd will lay down his life for his sheep. It's his livelihood. And he loves them. He loves his flock. And our good shepherd is Jesus Christ. We are the sheep of his flock. And then people say, well, you're a pastor. You have a flock. I don't have a flock. I belong to a flock. The best I can be is the lead sheep. That's the best I can get. Some people say, well, you can be a sheep dog. No, I want to be part of the sheep. I want to follow the shepherd. And the sheep, now being lean sheep, though, you've got to be careful too. Because the other sheep will follow whatever the lean sheep does. The shepherd puts down a stick and the lean sheep jumps over it, the next sheep will jump over, the next sheep will jump over, and even if you take the stick away, at that point, all the sheep keep jumping. Because the lead sheep jumped. So that's a lot of responsibility. To be the lead sheep. You gotta act right.
down, brothers of Paul. Be careful to listen to the shepherd. Listen to the shepherd. That is where I call the church, and that's where I'm calling you. To listen to our shepherd, Jesus Christ. And the thing is about our shepherd, he is willing to lay down his life. Nobody's going to take it from our shepherd. Nobody's going to take our shepherd's life. When you say, who killed Jesus? You say, well, the Romans put the nails in him, and the Jews took him and made the charges against him. He laid down his life for us. He says, I have the authority to lay it down, and I got the power to pick it back up again. And we know in 3 days he did. He did. And he still shepherds us. And he says there's sheep in the other flocks. And he was talking about the Gentiles outside of the Jewish community, the Gentiles out there. He was going to call them too. So that all could come and be a part of his flock and follow him. Are you following Jesus? Is he your shepherd? Are you listening to his voice? Or are you being pulled astray? Folks, like I said, sheep on their own get themselves into a whole bunch of trouble. People on their own will get themselves into a bunch of trouble. Maybe we should be identifying with the sheep a little more. Mm-hmm. Because we find ourselves in greed and self-centeredness and immoral practices and hateful talk and hardened hearts. We're there, we are not listening to the shepherd. The shepherd is calling us to love one another, to care for one another, to help one another, to be his hands and feet in this world, and to listen to his call upon our hearts. I was going to say that someone here may be hearing a calling to step out and be one of the lead sheep in the flock. And if he is, answer. Answer the call. Maybe some of you are just wanting to have that relationship with Jesus Christ and to say, how can I listen to that voice? Today is a day to make a commitment. Jump in the flock, folks. You're welcome here. You're welcome. The altar's open. His heart is open. I'm excited that I not only get to be the lead sheep here again, I get to be the lead sheep downstream. But know that I'll be listening. I'll be listening for a shepherd's voice. Thanks be to God for our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Our closing hymns.